Hello, smart apes. Do you think that you are in control of your actions? Do you want to know why you clicked on this video? Well, in that case, imagine your brain as a compact supercomputer. It processes inputs from all your senses: vision, hearing, smell, taste, touch, balance, temperature, pain, and proprioception. These inputs shape the outputs, the actions we take, our thoughts, and our words. Throughout history, humans have gotten from stupid to smart to stupid again. Evolution, the driving force behind this transformation, operates on a simple principle: genes that reproduce successfully are preserved, while others are left behind. In each generation, a person typically inherits around 30 mutations. Approximately 1.5 of these mutations are harmful, and just 3 out of 2,000 mutations are beneficial. These are small numbers, especially considering that a human has between 20,000 and 25,000 genes. In essence, we are genetically predisposed toward imperfection, but it's the rare beneficial mutations that lead to evolutionary progress. Determining when life began is a complex debate due to the ambiguous definition of life itself. The Oxford English Dictionary defines life as the condition, quality, or fact of being a living person or animal. Thanks, Oxford, now I know that life is being alive. A more useful definition considers life as anything capable of self-replication. Applying this definition, the first living entities were nucleotides, emerging around 4 billion years ago. The first of those nucleotides is called Last Universal Common Ancestor, or LUCA. It isn't a species, but rather a philosophical concept, the first living being. Since that point, these self-replicating entities evolved into more complex beings that developed brains, created societies, created science, philosophy, art, all just to reproduce. Those self-replicating beings evolved into a staggering diversity of species, with an estimated 8.7 million different forms of life on Earth. From the tardigrade that can support from -273 to 150 Celsius degrees to the immortal jellyfish that basically lives forever. Despite remarkable advancements in science, it still can't understand consciousness. Philosophy explains that our perception of control is merely an illusion. We sense various inputs, process them, and consider our responses. We call it free will. Since LUCA, humans have evolved conscience just so that they can reproduce better. While science has made tremendous progress, philosophy provides insight into the ongoing mystery of consciousness, remembering us that we are just puppets. Now, let's address the question: why did you click on this video? There could be many factors, but mainly curiosity. Curiosity is a significant driving force. It's a trait that allowed humans to survive and, in turn, reproduce and spread their genes. The desire to understand, learn, and explore is deeply embedded in our DNA. Now let's see some paradoxes. One such paradox pertains to sexual orientation. Despite the evolutionary focus on reproduction, individuals with non-heterosexual orientations exist across species. This challenges the simplistic view of evolution and highlights the complexity of human behavior. Another paradox relates to suicide, which seems counterintuitive to the drive for survival. Worldwide, approximately 800,000 people die by suicide each year, and it remains one of the leading causes of death among young adults aged 15 to 29. It shows the intricate interplay of genetics, environment, and mental health in our complex species. In conclusion, we are products of evolution, driven by the fundamental urge to reproduce. As we explore our origins, our future, and the mysteries of consciousness, we cannot escape our true nature as purely product of the traits of self-replication. Goodbye, smart apes.